Good morning, dear students. Let's continue with Financial Intermediaries Chapter 3, and the topic is Stock Exchange. So let's see the functions of Stock Exchange. In the previous class, we have studied about the meaning and definition of Stock Exchange, just to brush up, which says it's an association of persons engaged in buying and selling of stocks, bonds and shares for the public as guided by certain rules and usages. So in short, stock exchange deals with securities. It could be equity shares, preference shares, debentures, bonds or any other derivatives. So in today's class, we'll study what are the functions of stock exchange, which are very helpful for the society as well as economy as a whole. So let's begin immediately. The first point says the function of stock exchange. It is an economic barometer. The functions of stock exchange will have impact on economy. So stock exchange serves as an economic barometer that indicative of the state of the economy. It records all major and minor changes in the share prices. It is rightly said to be the pulse of the economy. So ultimately this point says that the stock exchange variation, stock exchange fluctuation will have an impact on the economy. So for example, students, if you look at any share prices of the company, it is directly related with so many factors which are interconnected. If you take an example of Satyam company, the fraud of Satyam company, who were indulged in insider training, and later on the fame of the company has come down, and it will surely have an impact on the share prices. And in one more cases, the company's investors have withdrawn their maximum number of shares, and it includes the board of directors or else those persons who are directly related with the company. So this behavior of withdrawing the shares or selling the shares from the company will have absolutely a negative impact on others who are looking at their decisions, because they are blindly following the same. So this becomes a mass behavior, and if majority of the people withdraw the shares from that company, then absolutely the demand for those shares will decline and the share prices also will come down. Whatever decision of the government, either positively industrial policies or else favorable changes towards the company or like against the company, based on the economic situation, ultimately it will have an impact on the share prices. Either it will go up or it will be down. If there are favorable industrial policies with related to the industries, then absolutely even the share prices of this company will shoot up with an expectation of increase in the dividend for the investors, because ultimately all the investors are expecting high rate of dividend for their investments with minimum risk. So if there is any speculation also, it will have an impact on the share prices. So ultimately, we can say this function of stock exchange or this variation in terms with many, many situations or many reasons which reflects the state of the economy. Okay. Then the next one is valuation of securities. That is nothing but the fixation of the prices of the securities. Okay. So the price quotation on stock exchange helps in determining the real worth of the securities. So its real worth is nothing but the intrinsic value of the shares. So in other words, the stock exchange is to be allowed for an opportunity to determine a reasonable and fair price of various shares or various securities traded on its floor through the market forces of demand and supply. The point to be noted here is the valuation or else the fixation of prices, as well as the rates of the securities, will be determined mainly through the supply and demand factors. More the demand, the rate or the share prices will be high, as well as with reference to the supply. If there is more and plenty of supply of shares in the market, then also the prices will decline. So you know the economics rules, that is law of demand and supply. The securities offered by the companies that are profitable and growth oriented tend to be valued higher. So valuation of securities helps the creditors, investors and government in performing their respective functions. In the next function of stock exchange, it ensures transactional safety. All the savers or else all the investors are absolutely require safety of their funds, because it is their hard-earned money which they are investing in variety of securities. If you ask your elderly person at home, their preference will be always in public sector banks. Why that, students? Because it ensures them the safety of their funds. They are very much confident of their funds. Even though it is a moderate interest, after some particular period or after completion of the duration, it is absolutely fixed for their investment, whatever it is assured for them. So it will not vary in spite of there is a change in the market strategies. So similarly, to some extent, the transactional safety is given to the listed securities in the stock market. Okay. And the listed securities are done after verifying the company's position only. So if they want to, the companies want to issue the shares or debentures or any derivatives in the market, they have to be listed in the stock exchange. And it's a detailed procedure, students. And that listing cannot be done without verifying the company's financial position, which is done by stock exchange operations. So all companies listed have to adhere to the rules and regulations as laid out by the governing body. So when they have complied with all the rules and regulations and all these companies' position is verified by the authorities, then absolutely in those companies, either it could be blue chip companies or else the companies which are sufficiently earning the profits and who are capable of giving the fair rate of dividends as they have assured earlier, will only be eligible to trade in the stock market. So as an investor, what is the duty? To see the financial credibility of the companies, select the right companies and invest and earn. So this type of transactional safety is given by the stock exchange, because once the listing is done, all the verification is also done by the governing body, that is SEBI. The next point is contributor to economic growth. So we can also call it as economic barometer. Barometer, you know the meaning, is an instrument which shows the changes in the temperature of the atmosphere. So similarly, it is called as economic barometer. In what sense? Because the stock exchange acts as a platform for trading of securities of the various companies under the same platform. So this process of trading involves continuous disinvestment and reinvestment, which offers opportunities for capital formation and subsequently the growth of the economy. Students, in economics, you might have studied the economic growth starts from an individual, right? Even the economists who are debating that even the household, the income of the households also should be considered for calculation of GDP, that is gross domestic product. Okay. So wherein when the GDP is increased, obviously the capacity to earn more also will be enhanced for the nation. So here, with reference to stock exchange, when we are trading, From all the angles, the country's main motor will be to what? There has to be more capital formation so that they will have a favorable balance of payment. Because there are all import and export in the country, and with the less import, okay, so the export will be more, and even in case of import, they have sufficient funds to pay off. So either through public sector banks, private sector institutions, intermediaries, or else even in the form of stock exchange, that is in the form of shares and debentures as well as other derivatives, they are trying to collect the more volume of capital formation. So one more word which is here, that is investment and disinvestment. The process involves continuous investment and disinvestment. Unlike your fixed deposit, RDs and other public sector investment avenues, in stock exchange you have better opportunity, like you can invest, you can de-invest. That is nothing but you can buy at your convenience and you can sell also at your convenience. Because since you are the owner of the securities, you will be studying the stock market thoroughly if you have that capacity. Then if you have knowledge of the stock market, and based upon the share prices fluctuation, you can take a decision, you can take a call. For example, you will tend to buy a company share when the share price is low, and on the contrary, you will try to sell the company share when the rates are increasing. So that is what is the general tendency of any common businessman. So that means you are free here, right? And again, the point comes, it depends upon the type of derivatives which you are choosing, whether it is open-ended scheme or closed-ended scheme. Whether securities are purchased under certain conditions, all has to be analyzed. So now that means it is absolutely making more people to invest in the companies, and it is welcoming the investment in various forms. Either it could be small investment, big investment, or else even the institutional investors also it is welcoming. Like institutional investors like banks or any other corporates, so whatever idle funds they have, they can reinvest in the shares, and they are trying to double the money. Okay, so this circulation of money is a continuous process which absolutely increases the volume of capital formation in the country. So in that sense, it contributes to the economic growth of a country. Then moving ahead, making the public aware of equity investment, because most of the people are unaware of investment avenues in the stock market. And the study says that, students, the favorite source of investment as of today also will be, for most of the people, it is risk-free returns, RIF we call it as, like banks, savings like LICs, or else post office savings, NSC, and other avenues wherein with moderate interest, like based upon the market rates, once the interest rates are fixed for the all years of investment, it will be same. But in stock exchange, it is not the case. Higher the risk, higher the profit is the mantra of stock exchange, wherein if you are ready to take risk, you can keep your securities for longer time, and you can avail more benefit from more benefits compared to your risk-free returns. But at the same time, there is a danger of losing money also. For both the things, you should be ready. But the wise decision would be the one wherein a proper allocation of funds is done by the investor. Like all your savings are not invested in any one company, assuming that there is expectation of hike in the prices in future. But on the contrary also, because nobody is giving you the guarantee. But ultimately, you have plenty of options, out of which the suitable options you can choose. So now here the stock exchange is helping you in providing information about the investing in equity markets and by rolling out the new issues to encourage people to invest in the securities. There are primary market, there are secondary market. So based on your interest as well as your requirement, like long term, short term or medium term, and with the ability to take the risk and expectation of returns, the decisions can be done. The next function of stock exchange says about the speculation, offers scope for speculation. What do you mean by speculation, students? It means making profit or loss through forward trading in shares. It's like a guess. What you are guessing? By permitting healthy speculation of traded securities, the stock exchange ensures demand and supply of securities and liquidity. For example, students, there is a speculation that there is the dividend rate of Infosys company is going to be hiked by 2% or 5% after 2 months. So it's a speculation based on their financial statements, what the speculators are doing in the stock market. So with this optimistic trend, who expect the rise in the future price of a security and start buying, while the pessimist speculators who fear future fall in the price of the shares and sell their shares. So the one speculator who is expecting the rise in Infosys company shares will obviously purchase more number of shares now. Okay. So, and on the contrary, the speculator, the pessimist speculator who is fearing the future fall in the price of any company share, for example, Wipro. He's expecting that after 6 months, the company's share price may fall down due to various management issues. Either there is a change of the board of directors, or else MD, or else the CEO is changed, or else the financial statement defects the loss, or else the fluctuation in the financial statements. Then obviously, what will be their decision? They will try to sell out the shares as soon as possible. So both optimist and pessimist speculators you can witness in the stock market. So that's the reason, students, the stock market is called as gambling. Okay, so you should be ready to earn more profit, you can enjoy more profit, and at the same time there is a threatening of losses also. So proper speculation leads to minimized risk of losses. So continuing further, I think the same point has been repeated, offers scope for speculation. Then the next one is, it facilitates liquidity. Okay, so the term meaning liquidity, you know, easily convertible into cash. That is one of the most important role of stock exchange, which ensures ready platform for sale and purchase of securities. So please remember the connecting point, students, here. How there is a liquidity which is brought in the stock exchange? It is through sale and purchase of securities at their convenience of the investors. So they can take a decision at any time. So based upon the speculation, with reference to the previous point, if they expect fall in the prices, they absolutely sell off now. If they expect rise in the prices of a company in future, they will tend to purchase more. So in both the cases, investment and disinvestment can be done very easily. Okay, so this gives the investors the confidence that the existing investments can be converted into cash, or in other words, stock exchange offers liquidity in terms of investment. You take an example, students, even though you have an asset of 50 lakhs worth land, but can you convert immediately into cash? You have 50 lakhs worth rupees asset, but is it easily convertible? No, you have to wait for the right people, or else the right dealing has to be done. So similarly, you have a complex, you have a infrastructural building. So all these assets, it is not easily converted into cash. It is not liquid asset. That's why we call it as a fixed asset. So I think the point is clear. The stock exchange gives you more opportunity for sale and purchase of securities easily at your convenience. So there is opportunity to have liquid assets or liquid cash easily. Then the next point says it is a better capital formation for the country. Already we have discussed the same. Profit making companies will have their shares traded actively, and so much companies are able to raise fresh capital from equity market. So profit making companies always tend to trade their shares in the stock market very actively. So even they can raise fresh capital from equity market, and this allocation of capital to the investors also done in maximum profit manner. So they can give fair rate of dividend, they can attract more investors, and at the same time the nation as a whole, they are witnessing better capital formation for securing their future. And the last point says that it encourages investment and savings. So stock market serves as an important source of investment in various securities which offer greater returns. So there are plenty of companies which are listed in the stock exchange with more number of shares and debentures, or else like their products are more financial products, we call it as. Then as an investor, we have more choice. More the choice, more the confusion, that also you have to agree, but still more opportunities to earn money according to our ability to earn and bearing the risk capacity. So investing in the stock market makes for better investment option than gold and silver. Okay, so ready investment as well as savings can be done in the stock market. So just in a nutshell, you can see and memorize the functions of stock exchange, which says it's a ready and continuous market through proper sale as well as purchase of securities, provides information about prices and sales, safety in dealings because SEBI is acting behind this, and mobilization of savings and capital formation. If there is more savings, obviously there has to be capital formation, and it is a barometer of economic and business conditions. Then better allocation of funds through various alternatives in front of you, and the system goes on. Okay, so with this we can conclude functions of stock exchange. So in the next class we'll study with dealers in stock exchange. There are various types of speculators, various types of dealers who are assisting the financial transactions in the stock market. Thank you.